Sisters.
Today, we will be showing you all a documentary about
a deeper understanding of drama.
Hope you enjoy it. To the character that you play on stage?
So when I'm playing Alice, I can really relate to her curiosity, like always just being invested in every little thing that she's like coming across to. Like whenever she's talking to a new person, she's just invested on why they act a certain way. You know, like I really relate to her curiosity.
For somebody who wants to be a main character in the show in the future, what's the advice you would give them?
Keep working. Like when you get ensemble, when you get like a small role, when you get an understudy, you have to keep working as much as possible. The directors notice every little thing that you do, so put your all into everything. Like put your energy into every little character that you get, because that can really build you up there. And plus it can just build you with experience, and that's the main thing that you need to take away. Like put your energy into everything you do. Every time you act like you're on Broadway.
Listen. Okay.
What does drama club mean to you?
Okay. Drama club is just something that's so inspirational. It means a lot to a lot of people, and you know, it's just something you can have fun. Just, you know, express yourself. A very safe environment. Yeah.
So, what's the hardest part of running the soundboard?
Probably cues, honestly.
And feedback.
Yeah, I mean, there's the feedback of, like, if people are too close, but there's cues. And for example, like, if an actor misses a line or they skip a couple of lines and I'm not aware of it, I can't turn a microphone on in time. Or if someone comes on and I can't see it, it's a lot of just...
Usually, if there's a screen, all the mics
are on. Oh, yeah, if there's a screen, no one's mics are on. So it's a lot of just figuring out who's screaming. When are they screaming?
And people switch mics.
Yeah, and you got people switching mics, so it's who has which mic.
Do you all love your job overall?
I do. I love
I'm
it.
New to it. He's brand so new. Far.
He's brand new.
That's Michelle. How do you feel?
I'm gonna die.
You said what?
Nothing.
What you said?
I think I'm done. Okay. Thank you.
So, drama to me is really bringing to life like imagination and things that don't necessarily exist. And I'm not really an actor, I'm a part of the stage crew, I'm the stage manager. So for me, a lot of it is having to do with like building things and looking at something and like how can I bring that to life. So it's like bringing realism to things that aren't real, I guess, like fantasy.
A scene change is when backstage members, they'll move a set piece or props to the stage for the actors to act with.
Well, I'm ready.
Real.
Duh. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? That is Flower in the Pot, boy. That is Flower in the Pot.
Uh-oh.
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 Uh-oh. Uh-oh. My shoe. Oh. Oh, my. Look at there.
Where?
I actually don't look like a donkey.
Oh, you guys look so happy to be in part.
Bro, wait till the filmer gets filmed, bro.
Hello, what's the word? What's the word? Come take a tour.
Rush the corner.
Well, drama to me means creativity, inspiration, fun, and just hanging out with friends.
Real. Drama club to me is a place where I can be myself, and myself is extremely unhinged, so I can act extremely unhinged and no one bats an eye.
I love that for you. Next.
Some of you might be wondering why when actors come on stage, they have this. They have this because, you know, when we go up there, you know, yes, we can project our voice, but sometimes words might get lost and it might get missed. So this is a mic to make sure that everybody picks up everything and get it and really understand what the show is about. All right, y'all, we're here with Gabby. She's getting her mic. Yes. Showing y'all the process that we have to do in order to use the mics that I explained earlier. Hurry up, womp.
You know,
right now we're getting mic'd up. I have tape stain on my face.
So freaking cool.
This is so crazy. It looks like a DJ board.
Very odd. You know, I haven't been up here yet. They usually just give it to me downstairs.
Oh, okay.
Number three.
Is it better on the forehead?
It's better. It's best on the forehead.
Do you feel like any nerves or anything like before you go?
Kind of awkward.
I'd be feeling nervous before I come up here.
Thank you.
Do you want my cape?
No.
Okay.
Where do you put your mic at, Gabby?
I put this part right here. Then I put it like on like a shirt or something.
No? Oh, yes.
Watch out, Joey.
All right, well, Gabby, say bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye, Joe. And the people watching.
Yes.
We're gonna walk into the vlog, what's that thing called? Ah, why?
Bro.
Okay, y'all,
Lonnie,
it's time to wrap it up.
Lonnie, what are you guys doing here, Lonnie?
What are you guys doing here?
Yes.
Basically, like, we're stressing because it's the first show day. Our sets are not even done.
Whoa.
It's okay, but we got it.
Right.
Up and up. Hold!
Okay, wait, so I just climb up here like a... Okay.
Right here, show this part. Oh, you're from the back.
You may want to do a cutaway.
Is it recording?
Yes, it is.
Okay, we've officially got up from the ladder that we had to fight our life to get on. Oh. Yes, it is strange. You had a dream about this place before? Oh my God. Ooh, it stank up here. Let me not say that. Oh my God.
Hey. They cut my lights off.
They did.
Yeah.
This is scary. So like, oh my God, I'm a little baffled. So like how do you work this? Like how does it work? Like what's the hardest part? What is it all about?
Well, technically the hardest part. We have to take these off. Mm-hmm. We have to reassign them.
So
Mr. War wants, we have to change the movement so they're facing towards the stage.
Oh wow.
And we have to make sure they're working. That's the biggest part.
Do you enjoy doing the lights for the most part, though?
It's stressful, but it's fun.
What made you want to do the lights?
Well, I did it last year, but it was at the middle school. I didn't expect anything like this.
Yeah, this is a lot. Oh,
but they do get really hot, so you have to be really careful.
Oh, yeah, I'm burning up right now, and I got on a hoodie and all. This is not it.
And it was hot. And even with these on, it is still pretty warm.
Oh, yeah, then I wouldn't come up here on a day where it's 100. No.
Yeah, we're up here for a good couple hours.
Yeah, y'all really love drama, because I could never. I really could never. All right, well, thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Oh, girl, now we're going to have to come back down here. I don't know.
Drama Club is everything in the world to me. Drama Club was my favorite thing when I was a kid and when I was in high school, and now it is my greatest joy and happiness to get to share it with my students. It's the thing I look forward to about every day at work and the thing that makes me want to come back every day.
Before every show, our director, Mrs. Hansel, or our assistant, before and
are
after
you afraid of her?
And show.
We can all lose our heads.
I'll open the door without knocking.
do you relate to the character that you play on stage?
Well, I guess in a way, you know, he's not really understood. He uses a lot of like sophisticated language, and I guess I can kind of relate to him in that way because people don't really understand me either.
Right. I can relate to being goofy and acting dumb. And that's what my character is.
Our first show is tomorrow. How do you feel?
I feel great. I feel like everybody's going to really lock in and just, you know, make it poppin'.
Real.
Yeah.
Oh. Our first show is tomorrow. How do you feel?
Great. It's beautiful.
Oh, okay.
I'm so excited.
Oh, okay. Our first show is tomorrow. How do you feel?
I'm so happy right now. I'm so excited. I'm really in a good mood.
Real.
We really do have to hurry up the
thing
she says.
Why not?
But live, laugh, love.
All right. Our first show is tomorrow. How do you feel?
Stress.
Real? You feel anything else?
It's very.
What scene are they on?
I don't know. I have to
record. Okay.
Okay.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. How do you feel?
Great.
That is great. Yes. Yes.
Having some great tea.
Yeah.
Hey, how do you feel?
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah,
I could be so. It's, you know how it's so like nice and hot up there.
Yes, it is.
So nice and warm up there.
No. Yeah. Yeah. That's why I said we only went up there one time. Never again. Never again. Never again.
So that, yes.
Down to 10, please, for number one.
I took on stage, how do you feel?
I'm excited.
You're excited?
Yeah.
Is that it?
I'm nervous.
Nervous?
Not really, I just
what? We're literally in the middle of the show and he's recording. I don't know what's wrong with him. It's something going on in his brain. He's like, he's messed up mentally, because what is he doing?
Okay. How's feeling after the first show?
Light work.
I don't think people like me as much as I thought they would.
Oh, I like you. Have
Thank
some,
you.
How do you relate to the character that you play on stage?
I guess I relate to her because of the fact that, like, she has to go through a lot of trials and errors to actually understand, little pun, have to understand what the whole point of all of this is, and I think that I do that quite a bit. And also how she kind of gets a little bit irritated towards the end because she's like, you know, I want to go home. So.
Well, this is the workshop for me. Really build all the stuff from our set. Like, I don't know if you've seen the set already, but it's like where all the stuff gets built, like the planning and everything really happens. Like, we got all our wood stuff over there, our beds, all the stuff we really use to build. But,
I feel like the first show, Miss Iso.
Yeah, you did great.
Yes, yes.
Two more.
So how do you relate to the character that you play on stage?
Well, the Cheshire Cats, in my opinion, is very confident, very sly, and he likes to help out, but also watch chaos unfold without letting it get too bad. So that's how I kind of feel like I relate it, because I like watching things from afar, but if it gets too rough, I want to...
Here's the lovely backstage working on some of the props for the show. Working really hard, as always. Best backstage in the world. Let's make a map.
Yeah.
Zechariah Emmanuel Henry.
Hi, Tyler. Tyler, mom! I'm thinking, stop!
Your mic.
Damn.
Make
sure it's not getting
it. Where's the
time? We're
running.
I'm just here to get sticky.
Bro. The no shoes are insane, bro.
Hey, Hera, your mic is still up here. I was told to yell at you.
I saw him.
Yeah, get your mic on time.
Guys, that was a close one.
Once, doce, trece, trece.
I know, but we have four people coming.
Yeah! Oh, come on! Come on! Yep, at least four people. Clap it round. Clap it round.
The energy yesterday was palpable. It should be the same way today. All right?
Hey, off with your heads. Ready? One, two, three.
Off with your heads!
You got two.
Are going to open soon, so I thought I'd stop by and give you a few reminders. And the moral of that is, listen if you want to survive until intermission. Anyway, flash photography is prohibited. Food and drink items are not allowed in the auditorium, otherwise the Queen will be very angry. And the moral of that is, remember what I said if you value your head. Alrighty, I have to get rid of this little pig so I can go play croquet with the Queen. Enjoy the show!
Off with their heads!
Hey Lonnie.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing?
I'm recording.
Oh, sorry.
I'm doing good. I'm doing good. How about you, Lonnie?
I'm doing so freaking good.
Bye, Mr. J. You look so happy to be here.
My mom.
Made cards for our directors because it is closing night. We're gonna give it to them on stage after the show.
That's surreal. I need your help.
Honestly, because
we perform with energy and excitement and be that person that somebody is paying to come see. Everybody out there, whether it's only $3 or $5, is paying to see you. Okay? And they want to see, I'm sorry, they're not actually paying to see you, they're paying to see the characters in the show, right? They're paying to see this show.
I know that you've got in you an incredible show. And I think that Friday was good, still wasn't that incredible show. I think tonight will be an incredible show. Here's why. It's your last time running it as this character with this crew doing this, okay?
We're standing there taking your bow tonight. Look around. Take it in. Enjoy it. Build that core memory in your brain. Let it live there forever, because I promise you, these are the ones that are gonna stick around.
Three, the wind is coming. One, two, three.
The wind is coming!
And a door two to two.
I think it's hard to say.
Welcome to Wonderland.
Whoa! Did I just see you take a picture of us performing? Remember, there's no flash photography allowed in Wonderland.
And also food or drinks, you know.
Yes, that's what I meant. Chessie, please tell me how to get home again.
You'll have to find it yourself. And more than just I are watching you, they are too.
I hope you all enjoy the show.
Oh God, hi.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
My last time I got to hear Beautiful Soup. I love Beautiful Soup.
Bro, you're so late.
It's tradition here at Cremoni High School that at the end of each show run, we like to celebrate our esteemed directors you can see in the back there. So,
and then last
now.
After party.
Winter, you trying to do the dog bark? I'm trying to kill
you. What did you guys think of the show? That's great.
It was my second time watching it. It was awesome.
Thank you.
We saw opening night and we saw ending night. So it was really good.
Thank you.